Thank you very much. First of all, I want to thank.
Innanzitutto vorrei ringraziare tantissimo il progetto Creative Museum per questa bellissima iniziativa e per l'invito, gentilissimo, cortese. Anch'io spero di non deludervi nel farvi la mia presentazione, che sia utile alla comunità dato l'argomento del progetto. Ma a questo punto vorrei parlare in italiano, se me lo permettete, visto che la maggior parte del pubblico locale è italiano, con la traduzione verso l'inglese, perché così mi sento più a mio agio. Passo all'italiano.
Sono Maria Teresa Natale, sono il technical coordinator di un progetto europeo che si chiama Atena Plus, un progetto che è coordinato dall'Istituto Centrale per il Catalogo Unico delle Biblioteche, un istituto del Ministero per i Beni e le Attività Culturali, che da molti anni si occupa di linee guida e coordinamento nel settore della digitalizzazione per i beni culturali. In qualità di coordinatori di questo progetto coordiniamo un consorzio di 41 partner da 20 paesi europei e siamo un progetto dell'ecosistema di Europeana. Conoscete tutti Europeana? Sapete di cosa si tratta? Nel bene o nel male. E quindi nell'ambito di questo progetto, oltre a contribuire con 3 milioni di dati al portale europeo provenienti da diversi istituti culturali, biblioteche, musei e archivi, oltre a questo sviluppiamo una piattaforma per la gestione di terminologie multilingue condivise e poi sviluppiamo tool creativi per il riuso, per l'uso e riuso del patrimonio culturale, ed è proprio su quest'ultimo tema che si basa la mia presentazione. Noi siamo quasi arrivati alla fine del progetto, abbiamo realizzato diversi tool e pensiamo che si possano essere sostenibili e riutilizzati a lungo nel futuro. Qui in questa schermata vedete appunto una sintesi dei vari progetti che vi andrò a presentare, un tool che si chiama Movio per la realizzazione di mostre virtuali, realizzato da una ditta italiana che si chiama Meta, una ditta toscana, poi due tool realizzati da un partner belga che si chiama Packed e che ha realizzato un tool per fare delle cacce al tesoro in città collegate con le istituzioni culturali, si chiama City Quest, e un altro tool che si chiama School Trip, che praticamente serve a fare in modo che i ragazzi con i loro professori, quando organizzano delle gite, possano già in anticipo crearsi delle guide di viaggio e non semplicemente fruire di una proposta di un'agenzia, ma quindi vivere la gita prima, durante e dopo. Oltre a questo vi farò vedere i culture map, sarò un po' più rapida su questo, però è un sistema per condividere i metadati di Europeana su una mappa generale europea, che poi può avere diverse applicazioni, e questa sviluppata da un partner sloveno, IPCHS, non lo so leggere come scioglimento di acronimo, e poi infine un'app che si chiama Urban Explorer, che è stata realizzata da un'associazione francese che si chiama Dedal e che è abbastanza creativa e innovativa. Iniziamo da Movio. Forse qualcuno di voi in sala già ne ha sentito parlare, perché questo è un progetto che è nato innanzitutto con un finanziamento italiano della Fondazione Telecom Italia nel 2011, e dal momento che ha avuto molto successo si è riuscito a garantirne la sostenibilità ed un ulteriore sviluppo nell'ambito di questo progetto Atena Plus. Movio è uno strumento dedicato, cioè ovviamente il target target sono gli utenti finali, però è uno strumento che si rivolge a tutti i curatori museali o a chiunque fa mostre anche nell'ambito di altre istituzioni culturali, biblioteche, archivi, associazioni, pro loco, chiunque, pubbliche e private, che vogliono realizzare una mostra virtuale. È un qualcosa che oggi come oggi non esiste, cioè siamo gli unici a avere fatto una cosa di questo genere, forse non sarà perfetta, però è sicuramente uno strumento.
Another thing to be said is that this tool is based on guidelines that are available, guidelines for the creation of digital exhibitions created by the ministry under Indicate project, directly downloadable online, that have been made, that represent the first attempt to put together and draft guidelines as well as a toolkit for those who wanted to try and create and develop digital exhibitions very quickly. This slide is very busy. What are the advantages of a digital exhibition? A lot has been said about digitization. And I know that all these things are already well known, and this slide and presentation will be available to you. But let me go back to the tool that has been developed. Why is it innovative? First of all, it is a content management system for digital open source materials that is mainly based on the very idea of having the opportunity to create a conceptual map, and through this conceptual map you can connect different types of contents. But SMCMS includes a set of tools, storytelling, timeline, map management, photo gallery, image hotspot, Google Map management, etc. As you can read, through the integration of all these various tools, a curator can therefore create digital exhibitions in quite a user-friendly way, thanks to a tutorial that are made available or through a very short 4-hour long training course. Everyone can become able to organize on one's own one's digital exhibition. Within the framework of Athena Plus framework, the important thing, interesting thing, is that through partners, features have all been enhanced altogether, rather than waiting for the company to come up with something. And so the final result resulted from everyone's contribution, who wished to enhance what they expected in terms of final output. We can therefore manage different types of languages, multilingualism of contents, CMS, graphical templates, and we do have the various tools that have already been mentioned. Without entering into the details of it, just a few examples of our partners who organize a few creative digital exhibitions. And that's quite interesting, because these various digital exhibitions have been organized in various types of languages. And so thanks to our partners, we have seven language archive available, which is absolutely fantastic. This is the timeline, maps, and the possibility to have hotspots to take a few pictures and include comments and links and clouds and games within the exhibition, and so on and so forth. And so this is the back end, which shows how simple and user-friendly it is. Another important thing to be said, since we are part of Europeana ecosystem, we also introduced the Europeana API, starting from that object data. data sheet. We can link it with other types of objects within Europeana network, just in case we wanted to come up with data sheets for a certain type of audience that wants to know more about it, or would like to know more about the history or a photo gallery and so on and so forth. As far as this tool is concerned, at the entrance you can find a few brochures that are available to you if you wish. A second tool is the so-called culture map that has been developed by the Slovenian partner to show the use and reuse of Europeana. Within Europeana framework, you can find a few millions contents, digital contents that are not put on a map. This culture map is intended to take Europeana digital contents. They will be referenced on a map, geographically referenced on a map. We had 3 million contents and we didn't know what to do about it, but the further step that has been implemented by IPCHS from Slovenia to make sure that through this culture map, e-culture map, you can display cultural objects, geolocate them, plan a cultural itinerary, or upload one's own content. Of course, I cannot enter into the very details of such an application, but you should also know that a few case studies and pilots have been developed together with the Rome Central Library that had organized an exhibition of Van Mittel paintings that showed a few views in Rome, preserved in various museums, and the true real exhibition was organized, and then afterwards these contents were used through the e-culture map app, and they would really find the true locations of the views that would be seen in these Van Mittel paintings. This is another example of a link with the street view. As far as school trip app is concerned, it's a tool developed by Packet, the Belgian partner, to plan school trips. It's very interesting. It's a true creative and co-creation moment, and it is a sort of networking between teachers and students. The teacher coordinates, creates groups, teams,
account ai singoli studenti e gli dà dei compiti, per esempio a uno gli dice
with accounts and tasks to the individual students, okay, please find the museums to be visited. Another one will have the task, tell us about the various types of means of transport that we have to take. Another one will have another task, for example, find pubs and night discos and other entertainment and leisure activities. And then together with the teacher, everything will be put together, and they will generate a PDF that will become the true trip guide for students before they leave on their school trip. So Europeana resources can be used in addition to others, and this makes the trip successful, and so that the trip will last longer even after it's over. We have tried it out. It does work. It's very easy. We are in contact with an Italian association so that we can introduce a few pilot projects in other Italian schools as well.
Quest, sempre Packet l'ha realizzata, e CityQuest è uno strumento per realizzare...
CityQuest is a tool to create treasury searches, treasury searches, a quest. It is an online quest. So a few spots are identified that are the various points of interest of this city quest. Then clues are given so that pupils is very nice for 7 to 11 year old pupils. Once clues are given that become increasingly easier, pupils are then allowed to get to the end so that the whole quest is completed. And once the quest is over, the app also tells you how long it took and how many clues have been used to get to the very end and so on and so forth. It is a game which is really appreciated by children. We Italian Partners, we organize two true city quests, real ones, within the project with the true users that we didn't know, so they have been found through internet, Facebook and so on. And these city quests have been organized in Parco della Caffarella in Rome, close to Appia Antica, with the natural landscape and archaeological and other cultural assets to be visited, and children have been involved with their teachers. This park is very big. They received a paper park map. They've been involved in this game. They really loved it, because at the end of the game we first of all asked them, did you have fun? And they said all together, yeah, yes. And then we asked them whether they learned something. Again, they said yes. And thirdly, we asked them whether they found it easy to use this app, and they said again yes. And fourthly, were they able to redo the itinerary together alone? Whether they had learned something about the garden map? And they all said yes, apart from one person whose sense of orientation maybe was not that good. And then we asked them what their feedback was, how to improve the tool. They were between 7 and 11 years old. That was very interesting, because a couple of pupils said, well, you see, as for the descriptions of the hotspots that are textual ones now, they should also be available as a sound app. Whereas teachers wanted children to have text, because the children are not very good at reading yet. Another interesting thing said by one of the girls said, well, we had fun, but you see, we need a prize, a true prize. What about the treasury? So it was not enough to say, okay, you are the winner because you were the best team, because you were the quickest one. So at least a candy, a biscuit would have been enough. A true, concrete, real prize, an award they were expecting, given also the age of these people. Okay, two more minutes, and the last app is Urban Explore. It is a tool for the creation of digital tourist cultural tours through storytelling, developed by France with the use of sophisticated technologies, including virtual reality. This is absolutely interesting tool. It is groundbreaking, but the difference about it is that it is the only open source tool that integrates as well proprietary tools as well, and de facto it is less user-friendly as against the City Quest School Trip and the Movio that are free for all, that are for free, and are easily usable, whereas the two Belgian ones have just been completed, but we don't have a big
feedback. E come si dice in Italia, non sappiamo a chi dare i resti, cioè abbiamo talmente tante richieste di utilizzo, abbiamo già 100 istanze più o meno attive o in lavorazione, e quindi siamo molto fieri, perché comunque sia un progetto italiano all'inizio che un progetto europeo alla fine hanno portato a un qualcosa di tangibile, per il quale stiamo pensando anche ad una sostenibilità possibilmente di un servizio sulla cloud, ma questo è qualcosa che ancora non esiste, ma speriamo bene. Tutte le informazioni comunque sono, per quanto riguarda i vari tool, sul wiki di Atena Plus, wiki.atenaplus.eu. Per gli italiani, su Movio c'è anche www.movio.beniculturali.it. E questo è il wiki e questi sono i nostri contatti. Grazie.